So hi again, everyone, and greetings. Welcome to a webinar series, A to Z of Algorithmic Trading. And we have not one or two, but 10 webinars scheduled for you. All these webinars are being delivered by different experts. If you're a beginner, you're requested to attend all these webinars live because they'll give you a very comprehensive overview about what is algorithmic trading and how to start algorithmic trading profitably. If you're having any issues in accessing the courses on algogy.com, go to your My Account page. For any issue, always remember to email support@algogy.com. For past webinar recordings, you can visit our YouTube channel. The link is given right on our homepage. So coming to today's webinar, that is handling data programmatically for algorithmic trading, and it will be delivered by Kapil. He is the MD of True Data Financial Information Private Limited. So the agenda for today's webinar is Kapil will discuss guidelines to fetching RT and historical data and saving it. He'll also give you some code example in Python, and he'll show you how to do it in other languages like Java, PHP, Node.js, C#, etc. A very brief introduction. Kapil is an ex-Air Force helicopter pilot, and he's been dabbling in this data vending industry since 2007. And also, Kapil was one of the earliest person to provide ME broker data feed in India. His company, True Data Financial Information, is an authorized NSE.x vendor and offers various innovative data plugins.
Good evening, everybody. I am Kapil Marwa from True Data. And today I'm going to be covering handling data programmatically with the True Data APIs. Before I start, I would like to thank Algogy and Saurabh, especially for giving us this opportunity to talk to all of you through his series of webinars. This is a wonderful effort he's put in. And if you are interested in any of these things, I'm sure all these webinars are going to help you a lot. Thank you, Algogy. Moving ahead, a brief introduction about what we are going to do today and about True Data. True Data offers NSE equity and FNO markets and has been doing that for 3 years. Why I mention this is because this is what you're going to get in the APIs, which we are going to talk about subsequently. And we are also adding MCX in July, which is about in the second half of July. We've already started a pre-launch offer for that. Market data is costly, so we need people to participate and help us with the pre-launch offer where we are giving a 45% discount. So once that is added, you will find that EQ, FNO, and MCX, all three would be available through the APIs, which I am going to talk about now. The products which we are offering as of now, most of you would be aware of our flagship product, which is Velocity. Velocity is a very unique market data plugin for AMI Broker, NinjaTrader 7 and 8, Excel, Advanced Get, Multicharts, Arthachitra, UpData, COM programmable libraries, Python, C#.NET. And to make it clear, the data goes into all of these applications at the same time on the same PC and of the same data subscription. Unlike other places where you have to buy it separately for separate applications, here you don't need to do it. And this is what I'll explain in the APIs which we have made, which are tailored to keep adding multiple applications to Velocity. So if you are an application developer, for you, connecting to Velocity and already immediately connecting to a vast number of people who are already using Velocity for AMI Broker, NinjaTrader, etc., Excel, your application would be added easily and people would be able to use it without paying anything extra for the same. Then we have launched another application. If you are aware of Iris and Falcon in the market, a similar type of application, we have launched Cheetah. It's a market scanner, gives all sorts of queries, both tick query, market watch. It also gives advanced queries, and it's an analytics application. I have it open here, just a glimpse for you. This is the application wherein you have a market watch here and the charts are here. You can have lots of things here. This is an ADS. We'll have a full webinar for this subsequently if anybody's interested. But just as of now, I'm just showing you what all is available. You can see the advanced decline ratios over here. You can see, say, a market eye wherein you can set a group, say, CNX 500, and choose what you want to see in real time. With high of the day, gap up, you can select these things. Field gap, it has hit yearly high, open interest has increased, blah, blah. All these things are there. Above the VWAP, no sellers, Nifty Bank, Nifty. This is just one of the features which is available for bullish and bearish conditions. And then you can start tracking them in real time. As of now, the market is closed. But in real time, as these things are hit, you will see them in real time. Similarly, there are other things here, tick query, signal scanners. You can scan specific signals which you want to see. For example, there are a lot of signals which you can add. You know, it's crossing some moving averages or certain accumulation or two moving averages cross, cuts above, is above this line, is at the day's high, is any candlestick pattern which it meets. So we'll go into details of all this. There are videos on our website which you can see for this. If you go to our website, you'll be able to see them. From our support, you can go to videos and you can see them. We have a vast number of, because too many queries for these are coming. You can see real-time quick tick queries and you can see a lot of other basic charts.
In this video,
we'll
be talking about a special feature called tick query.
So things like that. So we are not going to cover this over here at all, but I'm just showing you what are the possibilities here. Okay, coming to the APIs now. We'll be talking about these four APIs today. And first of all is the Signal R API. Now, a Signal R is a new library which I'll be talking about, which is able to push the data from our servers via WebSockets and also SSE. SSE is server-side events. WebSockets may not be available everywhere, and that is when SSE, Signal R, is able to fall back without changing any code. So that's a push API, asynchronous. Then our data also goes into Excel. Some people have been querying us for getting the data into Excel and use them subsequently from there. I'll also show you a small example of that in Excel. And then we have the COM API. The COM API is the API which is connected to True Data Velocity itself. It needs to be activated from our backend. And when you use Velocity and you need an API, you will be able to get it from the Velocity itself, which I will show you today. Then also there is HTTP and REST API, which is very, very simple to integrate. I will show you various coding language. You can code it almost in any language and it's very simple and you will see real-time data. So what I've done today is, because it's late in the evening, I have already recorded some of the things for today during today's live market, so that you're able to see the data flow in all these real-time APIs. So let's start one by one and feel free to ask any questions to Saurabh. He'll direct them to me and I'll answer them. So what is the Signal R? So first of all, we need to understand, I would request you to Google it if you're interested. SignalR.net is the website. And Wikipedia also has a lot of information about this. It's a software library for ASP.NET, where the server sends asynchronous notifications to client-side web applications. With SignalR and over WebSockets, we are able to send almost 10,000 symbols at a time. So if you have an application where you want to scan, you will be able to send almost 10,000 symbols you have tested with. Even if you degrade performance, will not fall below 7,000 to 6,000. So this is the capability of Signal R, and it's a new library and developer. It makes it extremely simple to add real-time web functionality to your applications. We'll give you, if you're interested, once we are ready with this, we are about to launch it. We're still in the testing phase. We'll give you sample applications also, which I'll show you here. And with web, what is real-time web functionality? It's the ability to have your server-side code push content to connected clients as it happens in real time. You may have heard of WebSockets. It's a new HTML5 API that enables communication both ways. SignalR will use WebSockets normally, wherever it is available. Most browsers are providing WebSockets. But where it is not available, it will fall back to SSE, which is called server-side events, and to other technologies without any requirement of changing a code. So that's the power of SignalR. What this means for us? This means that instantly, as soon as the data lands up on the servers of from NSA, it will be pushed to you instantly. We have also enabled another feature with SignalR, which has been on high demand. People have asked us to give them APIs wherein they get candles after the time is up. For example, you want to give you want to see 1 minute candles as soon as they are over. So you, with SignalR, what you can do is you can have a list of 100, 200, 500 stocks which you are subscribed for. And once subscribed for, the server will keep a track of the data. As soon as the 1 minute candle is complete for all these stocks, instantly the 1 minute candle will be sent to you as an OHLC. This is an example of SignalR. You will not have to request for anything at all. Only the first time you requested as by subscribing to it. Having subscribed, it will continuously send 1 minute candles to you throughout the day. So this is just one example of what it can do. It's very powerful, and go through it if you're interested, learn about it. And if you already know about it, then get in touch with us soon. We are going to launch this soon for web applications. So I have with me an example to show you in the meantime. This is a SignalR API. And it's a small application. Don't judge it by the looks of it. It's just a test application, which I was just testing today. And I will show you how it works. Okay, it is asking for the authentication key. So I'm starting this video. This is a video I took today morning, and it will show the data for today around, we'll see the time. I think it's around noon. And now I would have logged in using another code somewhere, and I'll get the key, which I will put here. You can see that this is a recording. So I'm just, this is the key has been put here. And when I click on start streaming, the connection would be established and we are ready, waiting for the symbols to be subscribed. Now, using another code, I will subscribe to the symbols which I want to see. There you go. I've already subscribed, I had subscribed for some 25 symbols. And all these 25 symbols are now flowing into the browser and they are updating. This is the timestamp, this is date of today. Yes, this is around 12:15 or so. The data is updating. And these are this is the LTP, the price, the quantity, the volume and change. Everything is available, even bid and ask, but because this was a test just to show you, we had quickly put this up so that we can have something up to show you. So like this, you can put thousands of symbols and without a problem, they will all flow. Just like they are continuing to flow here. So this is not fully ready. There are some flaws which we are going to correct in the next coming days. And then this will be available if anybody is interested with this. So till your connection is established, the stream will continue to flow. If it breaks, you will need to resubscribe to the symbols which you had subscribed for. Now, I'll show you another test implementation which somebody was trying on similar lines, a little more decoration there, just to show you. This is not the best implementation, but a little more decorated and using top gainers and losers, some charts here and there. Whenever you click on any symbol here, the chart will update here. You can also have a full screen chart. And you can have a lot of things, a high, low, average. Everything will flow here without a problem. So you can add color, you can make any application, you can add. We are not a broker, so you can get broker APIs and connect to that with this data, multiple brokers if you require. and you can make applications on those lines. So why I cover this is because the power of SignalR here is very useful for algo trading. And if you are able to directly push everything instantly, it makes a lot of difference in your algo trading. Okay, that's for the SignalR and the WebSockets. And now I'll come to the other implementation briefly, which is Excel. Now, True Data Velocity already connects to Excel, and a lot of people use it for real-time and historical data. True Data Velocity itself is able to give historical data, and that I will show you after I show this. So this is, I just started the application here, and this is a sample Excel sheet where I've put in a few symbols. Then you can see the last, the change percent, open, high, low, close, trade volumes, open interest, bid, ask, bid size, ask size, previous open interest you can get, and the average traded price. These are the fields. The formula is something like this. RTD function of Excel is used, and this is the formula. Once you do that, you can see it here. Like, for example, I've just added a few options here and converted them to chart. Now if I make it say Nifty, and I make it Bank Nifty, we'll get the Nifty put option chart for Bank Nifty. You can see how fast the data came, and 27,000 call. There seems to be some action here in Bank Nifty. So that's Bank Nifty 18 June, for all the options, and this is for Nifty. Similarly, you can just change here. Suppose you can make anything. You can make hundreds of symbols here. I'm just using this. If I make TCS here, you'll find the data is updated for TCS over here. Let's put in Zeal and see. Yeah, you can see all the fields for Zeal are updated. If you are somebody who's interested in using this Excel and connecting it to any application or using it for any calculation purpose. If I find a lot of people who are doing pair trading, etc., they are using this. Some option analysis, people are using this. And maybe if there are some developers, they'll be able to connect this to other applications where they can, you know, fire orders from. The only thing about Excel is it will update every second or maybe more. Could take sometimes more, and Excel sometimes behaves funny if it doesn't get all the rights and all. Microsoft ensures that you need to give full administrative rights to Excel. So you just can't start the application and expect the data to flow. You'll have to give full administrative rights and make sure that it has the permissioning. And that is where you have to be careful and get used to using it. A lot of open interest charts and etc. we have on our website. You can see we have put there in on our website, and if you're interested, you could go there and see, you know, what all we have just shown some possibilities over there, but maybe you could you know, go and see it for yourself and, you know, find out more about it. I think it's over here. We have a lot of articles. You can see this is a small Excel chart where you know, the data will flow. And you can create things like these. This is explained here, and you can also see a similar options pane chart done here. So if you're interested in more information, please go there and have a look on that. Similarly, we have the option, people have been asking us about historical data. There's an add-in here. With this add-in, you can download things like, suppose, daily history. And this will open up this tab here. Let me say Nifty Future Continuous. And say just for a few days, I'll download it. And I say OK. And it will download it here. I think it's downloaded here. OK, here it is. Already downloaded. Sorry, here it is. This is the one which is downloaded just now. And this is from this date to all the way right. You know, whatever date range you give, the data will be downloaded over here. I was testing this earlier, so I got confused with which one it was. One. So similarly, we can even download the bar data. Suppose bar is 1 minute. You can have, see, the options are 1 minute, 5 minute, 15 minute, 60 minute. You could have almost anything. Let us leave this, whatever the date range is. And there it is. You can see the data has already come with open interest. And you can see it is 915, 916, 917 from 4-6. So this is another feature. Even tick history can be brought. Let us download tick history for the last from 10th onwards. And there you are, from 11th, it has given us this tick history. Because 10th was a Sunday, I guess. So it has given us this tick history over here. So you can get the history here like this without any problem. And for a date range or so, even Velocity has a feature here, which if you're not aware, if you're using Velocity, all you need to do is just right click here, import. You can import or export data of any selected symbols, you know, give or to here. All these are, in a way, some sort of an API. That's why I'm talking about it. You know, you're getting data in your hand. Say, I'll just get Bank Nifty and Nifty. Let me try. Okay. So next, let us take all kinds of data, daily, minute. Now, I'll just, before we do that, I'll show you on the desktop. We'll get it here on the desktop, this data. And whatever the date range is, about 1 month of date range. And let's get it on the desktop. It will process it. And here this folder has been made with the timestamp of now. And it is downloading tick data also and historical data over here. Once it's done, we'll be able to see. You can see it here. It's already downloaded data. This is Bank Nifty. We asked for about a month of EOD. This is EOD. And we asked for, let us see, 1 minute of Nifty. There it is. 1 minute of Nifty. All the data is here. You can use it as you wish. All the data has been downloaded. Then we have tick also, separate folders, separate name, everything is neatly come there. You can see the tick data has come here from 915, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 9. You can see all the tick data is there directly from Velocity. And even from trade 5 minutes, we can, sorry, this has not come. Anything which doesn't come is because you haven't updated it here. If the data is not here, you have to pull it from the server, for example. How do we pull it? First, you need to pull it here, right-click, update from feed, and select a particular symbol, Adani port, say. Next, select whichever time frame you want. I did not select 5 minutes earlier. That's why the data is not there. I need to select all or select a particular one and update it from feed. So what will happen is it will update it from the feed. And there it is, Adani ports. It become green. That means it's updated till today. All the three, this has become green, green, green. That means it's updated till today. Yellow means there is some data, but it's not updated till today. Because I've not seen it, or I've not used it, or I've not called for it. That's why. In some, you can see tick data. I've not called for these talks, but there is some 1 minute and 1 day data. So things like that. So most of you are already aware about all this. But these are the ways in which you can get the data which you're looking for, both in Excel and directly from Velocity.
Thank you, Kapilji. There's one question which may be relevant right now.
Okay.
So Mr. Sanjay is asking, what is the minimum recommended data rate required for instant data receiving?
Oh, sorry, I didn't get the question. Again?
He's asking, what is the minimum recommended data rate? Probably he's talking about the data update frequency in time. Okay, so what is the minimum recommended data rate required for instant data receiving for how he wants to trade?
Okay, see, this it depends on your application. I would say for retail traders, even if it is about 2 to 3 seconds late, may, but a high frequency trader would need it in microseconds or nanoseconds. But it depends on what you're actually doing, what your strategy is. Are you too close to being absolutely accurate? You will never be. There will always be, even for high frequency traders, there is a latency. It will be in microseconds or nanoseconds, but there will be. So as you go further away from the exchange, if you are somebody who's further away, for example, our line which comes from exchange takes 1 to 2 milliseconds to send the data from the exchange to our servers. And then we are sending the data out in a fraction of a millisecond. However, what is happening is that as the data goes from here via the internet, again, there is certain latency. If you're further away, our servers are in Bombay. If you're further away, then you will get a few milliseconds later. So you have to understand that about 1 second or 1.5 seconds is not a problem for any retail trader who's running a good algorithmic idea. Okay.
Thank you.
He's saying I meant to ask broadcast data speed required for intraday. Is that right?
Yes, yes.
I actually didn't get your question, Mr. Sanjay.
So probably I think he's talking about the data internet speed, like 2 Mbps or 1 Mbps.
Yes. So what happens is the more number of symbols you have, okay, the more number of symbols means the more data is going to choke your bandwidth. Okay, so you have got to have a good bandwidth if you want more symbols. If you want just 1 or 2 symbols or 5 symbols, then there's no issue. 2 Mbps, 3 Mbps will do. But there are people with us who are using 400 and 500. And then they will complain that the data is not flowing because their bandwidth is not enough to handle that. Also, when 500 symbols are coming into your PC must have a good CPU because things have to get processed at your end. It's just the data is coming raw. I'll show you now next. It has to be processed. The signals have to be processed. And then you need to have a good internet and a machine. So I would say if you are using about 50 to 100 symbols, I would recommend that your data, you must have at least 5 Mbps or above, minimum, to try and get that. Okay? And that is for the, as far as data is concerned. That is the minimum I'm talking about. And you need to give life because, see, when you call historical data from the servers, historical data is higher than, for one stock, the historical data is much more than the real-time data which is flowing. Because it depends on how much historical data you have pulled. If you're pulling a large amount of historical data, then you need more bandwidth. So that's the issue. The major choking is because of the historical data, not the real-time data. If you get my point.
Thank you. Yeah, thank you very much. I think this question comes up in everyone's mind. Even I also, you know, bother often like, what should be the ideal bandwidth for the amount of data I'm pulling in? Thank you very much.
Yes.
And Mr. Satish is asking that can we fire order directly from Ninja? So Satish, you know, you need to connect to your broker actually. So some brokers provide algo trading services and some do not provide algo trading services. And brokers who provide algo trading services may offer an API or a bridge. Okay. And we already had different webinars for them and you can contact support@algoji.com for any customization service about integrating NinjaTrader with your broker. So thank you. Kapilji, please continue.
Okay, fine. Thank you. Okay, now after all this, I'm going to talk about the COM API with Python. The COM API is a part of True Data Velocity. When you install True Data Velocity, you will find that we install an external API. And this external API is installed. Here it is. Here it is installed. We also give a sample Python code here. These are the samples. I've written some other codes also. Sample Python code, and then there's a sample COM code, and then there's a sample .NET code is given. It is all ready. There's in fact a project with a release available for you to run. You could run it. And you will be able to see the code working. This is a sample code we are giving. and you will be able to see the data flow here in this once you have started using it. As of now, I've not initialized it, but I'll show it to you in other sense over there. So these are the these are all the things that are available here, and this API is the one which we are pushing for people to connect so that more and more applications are connected to Velocity. So I will be telling you about the COM API we'll use with this application, and we'll use it with Python. And the environment I use is PyCharm and with Anaconda. Anaconda is a group of libraries. All the libraries which are required are there in that. And also we need the COM types package for the COM API. The COM type package in Python. I'll show you how to check that you have this package using the list and the search packages options for beginners. So let me start here. This is a PyCharm, my development environment where I do all the development. This is the sample code. I have already put it here, which you have seen. And this is the two data velocity external API. You can see that we have imported com types dot client as CC, and it's a very simple small code for getting on bar data, means candle historical data, 1 minute, 5 minute data, and on real time data for getting the real time data. So it's simple steps like creating an object and creating a sync to receive the events, and initializing velocity. The best part here is that even if velocity is not started, this call will initialize velocity. Like that we do for all applications. If you start AmiBroker and your default database is velocity, it will initialize velocity, meaning velocity will start on its own. You'll have to wait a little. And as it is started, I will show you, I have a recording here. And as it started, you will be able to get the data. Then it'll say velocity has been started. And then also today I've just added four symbols. This is a request for real-time updates. As I there are four symbols: Nifty, Bank Nifty Futures, Reliance, and Cipla. And then just here to call request real-time start, and all the symbols will start after having subscribed for them. Then history, I've asked for two symbols of history, Nifty and Bank Nifty. I've asked for end of day history and minute history. I'm not explaining the code in detail because it's pretty difficult to understand the code in a webinar. You can always come to us and take this code and sit and try and understand. But I'm just giving you the crux. So in this application, you have to first of all ensure that you install the external API application. You have to ask our support and get it activated from the backend. We offer a trial also, and you can use that. It's a free trial and try and get the data first here. Then you need to get COM types. We need the minimum version of 1.1.2. Anaconda comes with 1.3. Anaconda comes with 1.1.2. Now, how do we see? I use the terminal in PyCharm itself. I don't know if you've used this. The terminal here is very nice. So you can just come here, and you can get a list of libraries which are already there, in Conda. Let us see. So we are looking for all these lists, libraries which are already there. I am looking for COM types. So it says COM types 1.1.2 is there. And then there's 1.1.3, which I have done a pip install. A pip is the way to install libraries. And I've done that here. It's showing here. There's also another way to check the pip libraries, just by putting pip and list. With this, you can check all of them. Now you want to check some specific, I'll show you how to do that. So all these have been installed by me. And so you can see COM types must be here. Yeah, there it is. COM types has been installed 1.1.3. Okay. So now there's another way of doing this is just go and search. If you have installed Conda, say search COM types. You need to ensure that you have the right versions. Now, when I search for COM types, it'll say, let's see what it says. Okay, see, it says it's got all these 6.2, 6.2, 1.1, 1.2. Doesn't have 1.1.3. which is required. So then I'll search the pip and see. This will also get us the latest version available and the one installed. Let us see what it's saying. See here, comp types 1.1.4, pure Python comp package. Installed on our PC 1.1.3 and the latest version is 1.1.4. So you can use this. You can also, if it is not there, just what you need to do is pip install and install the package comp types, and it will install the latest package. If you already have, I'm not doing it because I already have it here. I don't want 1.1.4. If you already have a 1.1.2, then this is the command to fire upgrade comp types, and it will upgrade to the latest version. Just click enter and it will upgrade. So these are the ways of finding out that you have the correct version. This is important for this API, and that is why I'm mentioning and spending some time so that you find that the correct version is available. Most people have contacted us, said they're having trouble here because they don't have the right version with Anaconda, and they are not able to do it properly. Okay, so this is it. So, and this connects to Velocity. Now, Velocity is already logged in my case. It's already on and permissions have been given. And when I run this application, this code, it will just ensure that Velocity is running. Yes, there it is. So as of now, the markets are closed. And so what are we getting here? Let us see. We've asked for history for two symbols, I remember. So request ID, see, it says Velocity has been started. A request ID for days is Nifty-I, and you know, every symbol is given a request ID. For days is EOD, minutes for Nifty-I, and similarly on those lines. And these are already the historical data has come. Okay, it shows how many bars are there. The EOD data, you asked for some 7 days, so it has shown the bar count as 7. And then real-time events have started. So what happens is, when you first request the data, even now, you're getting real-time data events. How is that? You're getting the last cached data. That means that 1600, what was the data? That means you're getting the last cached data of Nifty 1. Similarly, you're getting Bank Nifty, all the last cached data. This is the history you're also getting here. This can be easily sent to CSV using a CSV reader kind of thing. You can use a, you know, read it all into a list, okay, and read it up over there, and then you can write it in a CSV. You have to use this function, this library, which is called import CSV. Just read a little about it, and directly you can push this to CSV if you want. Everything can go into CSV or in pandas libraries. So that will become a little complicated here for newbies, but this is how you can handle this from here. And so let me cover what does this all mean over here. For example, let us cover this over here. We have given a list of price types. What does it mean? So whenever you see RT update, it means a real-time update, Nifty-I 1. 1 means it's a bid. 2, ask. 3 is a high. 4 is a low. 5 is the open. So it's giving you all the fields, you know, before the real-time data starts. This will come even otherwise. All the fields will flow for you. And okay. So all the fields will start flowing here. And this has, you can see, bid, ask. If it is 1, it is bid. 2, it is ask. 3, high, low, change, trade volume, total volume, open interest, bid size, ask size, last. 4109 is the last traded. Last snapshot, 4111, trade volume snapshot, auxiliary. We are sending average there. Average is here. And previous open interest also we are sending in these fields. So you can see all of these here. This is the historical data which has come, which we had asked for. And all of this is coming. So I wanted to show you data in real time, how it is flowing here. Now that I've explained you from Velocity, now it is connecting to Velocity and pulling it. I did a video of the same thing today in the morning, so that you know you can see this over here. So it's the same thing. I'm going to run this video to help you understand better. So in this Velocity is not started, and as of now I'm just showing the code here. Let me move it a little forward. I've already shown you all this. Yeah, I'm showing here that, you know, request real time, already explained all these things. And end of day, minute, and tick. Tick history also, I've commented it out, but you can easily get tick history also. And these are the fields which I have just spoken about. So now I'll run the code here. And you'll see the same history coming, which is coming at non-real-time hours. So he has run the code now. I'll just move the screen up. And Velocity in the background. First of all, Velocity was not started. So now it starts in the background. And as it starts, you will see the data flowing instantly. Okay, there. Yeah, it shows data velocity is connected. And you will see the data has already started flowing here for Nifty, Bank Nifty, Reliance, and Cipla. Four things we had asked for. And that is the data flowing. I'm moving up now. And you can see all the data we had spoken about. Historical. This is the real-time data. This is the IDs we have requested. You can see there is a real-time event. All the data has started coming for Cipla. For Nifty futures, what happens is there's one snapshot code which comes for before the real-time code comes, and the first code of the real-time will be almost as same as the latest snapshot, after which it will start updating. It will show that it's a real-time event, and it will show that it's a historical event. Bar event is a historical, so both have been clubbed. As soon as the data comes, it is pumped here for you to see. You can see all the history here. I'm sticking to talking more about the capabilities than the actual code. Actual code, you can take it from us and you can go through it in detail. Okay. So that's the, that's already, I've shown you all these things. Now I'll just, I'm just showing all the fields. 4109 is the snapshot, last snapshot. One is the bid. For example, you can see 4109 is the last LTP of Nifty at 1358. You get the timestamp here. And trade volume is 10. Total volume is 11, is the total volume. One is the bid. 13 is the bid size. Two is the ask. 14 is the ask size. And similarly, now the real-time feed has combined with this. 4109 is the next price, and so on. You have the bid, total volume, total bid, ask, everything coming here.
Kapilji, there are a couple of questions. If you could take them now.
Just let this video get over. I'll take it after this video.
Right.
Yeah. It's just about a few seconds more. So these are the this is the data flowing here. Okay, just now I've just put it to the real-time mode. You can see it's already coming. The data is flowing for all these symbols. And you can even say you just want 4109. 4109 is the LTP. So if you just want 4109, you can ask that, okay, give me only 4109. And I don't want to see the bid, ask, or other things. Okay, for example, in this one, there's no 4109 in this one. It's only bid and ask. There was no trade over here. And there are some small ones where the only bid and ask have come. Whereas some long over here, you can see that that there's been a trade similarly like that. So that is how the data will keep flowing for you. You can have any number of symbols. Only thing is you should be able to process it. You can see the timestamp. I've opened the time here. This is the exchange timestamp, 50, 59, 01, 02, 03, 04. That much is a lag. This is my, I put it up to, you know, match my clock here. Just less than a second by the time it reaches here. So So that's about this. Please feel free to ask me any questions now.
Okay, so Ravi has a couple of questions.
Yeah, please.
He's asking that what are the limitations in terms of this live data updation? Like what would be the limitations in terms of frequency, number of symbols subscribed and so on?
Yeah, so with velocity, we have a limitation of up to, recommended is up to 300 to 400 symbols. So that is the limitation with velocity. That's the recommended figure. 300 for this. Okay. And frequency wise, you can already see it. It's by the time it reaches you, it's less than a second. It reaches you in less than a second from the time it timestamp of the exchange. So that is the frequency you have. So that is the question. What else?
And also, you know, the number of updates per second, I mean, limitations in number of the updates, you know, the number of data packets. How many times are, for example, if Nifty is very liquid and it trades a very, Nifty witnesses a very heavy volume in trading. So what is the limitation in the number of say, ticks received per second?
So all the ticks that have happened will be received irrespective of anything. Okay. And what I need to show you is that the bid and asks are much more than the actual trades. Okay. So the huge number of bid and ask are there always. Every bid and ask is not traded. So there are a large number of bid and asks which come there. And you will find that most of them are not traded. And the frequency means whatever is the, if you have 200 symbols, you will have, you can see here. I'll just show you. You can see that this is a trade 4109. Okay. But the others are all bid and ask, most of them. Let us go here. So see, for example, you have a lot of bid and ask over here. This is a bid and ask only, bid and ask only. Okay, so more of the, all, if you have 200 symbols, all the 200 symbols data will flow in one go, in a second. Okay, just now we have four, so you are seeing only four. I did less so that you can see. But otherwise, if I put more, you will not be able to see anything. The entire data will just run away. Okay, so you need to be able to process that data quickly if you want. So you need to take out the meaningful information you need and use it for your benefit. I've just used four so that you can just see what is happening. Okay. Yeah, what else?
Yeah, I think that answers the question. Thanks. Please continue.
Yeah, okay. So this is the API which many people have connected. In fact, UpData is a UK-based company. They have used this API to connect with us. Arthachitra is an Indian-based company. Joy has built the application. He has connected with it and he very easily. Like that, many people are connecting to it and are able to connect it with these. So if you want to use it for personal use, we are giving it. You can use it for your personal, calculations or whatever applications you want to develop or anything else, feel free to take a free trial. We give a free trial also if you're able to handle it. And a little bit of help, of course, is there from our side. Okay. Okay. Now I'll talk about another API, but that is the HTTP API in Python. It's a pretty simple API, and that's why I'm bringing it out here. A lot of people would like to use HTTP API with Python, and it is really a simple API. We have full documentation for this over here. Let me show it to you. And for example, this is our HTTP API, and we have, let's just see the contents. Okay, we have the master files are downloaded. Login rules are given, real time, you have to subscribe for the token. You'll be shocked to see the rate at which the real time data goes, even in an HTTP request. Okay, because the technology on the server side is very good and we're able to handle large number of requests, even on HTTP. Snap quotes are the quotes which are given for the last traded cached. Suppose you log in late, so you need to know what are the current rate, last rate, before you get to start getting the real time. You can unsubscribe the token here. You can unsubscribe a single token, multiple tokens. Then there's tick history. You can get the tick history over here. Number of days of tick history you want, or you want with a start date and end date. Okay, so things like that you can do. Then current day's history, 1 minute intraday history, and current day daily history. So current day's candle also keeps updating. You need to send a heartbeat to the server, and there's a logout. We also give corporate action details here. And then there are the historical APIs. We put the historical data on a separate server to help you with the current day and tick data and other things. And intraday bar history is available with start and end date ranges and backward from current date also. So in this kind of API, you can see all the response codes here. Say response code, if this API sends this information, it means this. It means it's sending you date and time, trade data, best bid ask, symbol, open eye, low, close average, interest, all these things are coming here. And what we do is we maintain a data sequence in this API. So you will not miss a single tick. That is the benefit of an HTTP API. People may not appreciate it much, but you will never miss a single tick in a HTTP because the sequence number will ensure that once you send a request, you will get a sequence number. Then the next request, you have to send that sequence number. So even if your internet got disconnected from that data till now, you'll get the entire data without missing anything. And your charts will never be repainted and they will always be correct. So that is the benefit of this. This document is available for people who want to see. It's a detailed document. It has all the information here. We also have a sample written by one of our well-wishers in VB.net using this API. Okay, he's written this, how to log in using this HTTP API, log out, subscribe to the symbols, market data, M data, it's called this command, and then get the how to do it, you know, get all these things here. It's pretty simple in VB.net. I can also show you in Java. The same code we can convert in almost any language and show it to you. In Java, you can see here, if you're a Java developer, this is the code. I'll give you the entire code for all the functions mentioned there. You can get use HTTP clients, logout, SnapM, in any language you want. Even Node.js.
There's one more question. Yeah, there's one more question if you could take it now.
Yes, please.
So Raghav is asking that is order book data available to a certain depth?
Yeah, so we are a level one real-time data vendors. So as of now, we have only the best bid and ask. That is why everywhere, wherever I've shown you, we only have the best bid and ask. Even over here, sorry. We don't have five levels of bid and ask. See, B is the bid and ask data, which I'll show you. It is in this format. B means it is. This is the bid quantity. This is a token number. This is the bid quantity. Bid quantity, ask quantity. So we only have one line of level one data. Level one means only the best bid and ask. We don't have 5 deep or 20 deep. Maybe later on, these APIs are from the exchange are costly. The exchange is charging a lot for giving us more depth. So till then, we are starting with this. Most vendors have this API.
One more related question, and I think you already showed the answer. So there's one more question that how many, you know, data fields are provided in this response code. So I think it's already, yes, you just showed that there are 15 or 20 fields there.
Yes, absolutely. So you can see the date and, okay. You can see the trade data. Okay. And the best thing which we do here, which nobody does, is that the exchange does not send the high and low as a trade. It just sends us that this was the high. It doesn't send it in the trade channel because the trade data which comes, which is this T, is trade data. But even for the brokers and for everybody, this high comes separately. It doesn't form a part of T, because of which most vendors and brokers I have seen, they do not show the high as a trade. So because even this 1 minute level one data is a snapshot in a way. Okay, it's a snapshot in 1 second how much data has come. So this high, what we do is we convert this H to T. So whenever a high is hit, you will find that it shows up in the trade data in our case. It does not show in the case of many vendors or brokers. So next time you see a high moving up very fast beyond the high, check the data and see if it has hit the high. So the high and the low, the same thing for the high and the low. This is what we do. We ensure that the high and low fall into the trades and cover the full range. So even some people have complained to us saying that your data is going way higher than what it is showing somewhere else. When we ask them to go to NSE and check the high and low, then they agree. But then they say, why is it not showing there? So we have no answer for that. This is what happens. You know, there are some ambiguities with services being provided somewhere. And we are trying. With all these inputs we have got from the community itself. And that is what we are trying to implement. So these are the fields you have, including average, open interest, index. All the indices we send continuously. We send the index data continuously, I will show you. The index value, close, high, all that. I'll be showing you this also. I'll just show this.
Thank you. I think this also answers another question. A lot of people, you know, tend to complain that the stock, you know, hit a certain high, but it is not visible on the chart. They say that exactly. They got their head placed, their stop loss triggered at a certain high or low, but that does not even come on the chart. So I think this explains why it doesn't show on the chart, you know, from those data vendors.
Exactly. So what happens is when you see our data, I've shown you some data here in tick. Okay. And what we do is a Nifty future. In the very first second, you can see Nifty 9:15:01. Okay. There are three ticks. Can you see? 9:15:01. And we have made it one volume on our own. Why? Because this was the open 10810. Today's open was 10810.85. But at the same time, it hit a high also of 10822.90. And then a low also. This was the low. Open was low. So you can see that we are sending the open, the high and the low at one itself. 9:15:01, we already sent you high and low. Okay. Whereas where you see anywhere else, you will find that only the open has come, nothing else. Okay. And the next rate is somewhere here, 4 or 5 it's hitting. So all the highs have come here. You can try our feed and you will find that we don't miss all these things.
This information should be very, very helpful, especially for intraday traders and scalpers.
Yes. And you can compare the feed. Even some international data vendors have not, I don't know why, they have not done this, unfortunately. And it's somehow people keep complaining and nothing is happening. So we need to, try and use this. Because it is a part of the field, a little tricky to implement, but we have been able to do it. Okay. So that it comes immediately at that time for all the stocks, because there are some 60,000 stocks and you'll do it for all of them. It's not just one. So all of these 60,000 stocks, there has to be something going on at the back end. So this is what it is. So let me continue. For any other questions for now?
Yeah, no questions. Please continue.
Yeah, so this is the last API which I was talking about. It's the HTTP API, and I have it here, and I call it the this thing API. We just use a simple import requests, and this is the I've given a random IP. This is the IP user ID and password, whatever you get. Okay, this IP user ID and password will be changed, of course. This is for your understanding. And then I have fired a logout first because I already logged in some other places. So I had to fire a logout first. And then this is simple code, HTTP code to log. I've logged out, I've given my user ID and password. That's it. It's a post response, logged out. Login, similar response. I just log in. And here I just fired an HTTP code and I've logged in. Okay. And the headers have been given. On the response, you get a, let us fire it and then see. When I'm going to fire this, okay. I fired this, first was the logout, Alex. It says you are removed, fired out. And then I logged in again. I had to log out because I was logged into Velocity. So that will otherwise not. So then I logged in and this is the key I get. This key has to be picked up. I picked up the key here. This is the key to be used subsequently till you are logged out. So it shows the expiry date and other things, markets used, number of symbols allowed, 350 symbols allowed in this case, things like that. And I have, for example, I have shown here, then I have to, after I've logged in again, I have picked up the key. Here I've picked up the key. I've split the lines over here, split these lines and picked up the first line, zero. You can see, that's all I've done. I just picked up this line and I have put about some 20, 25 symbols here. 25, 26 symbols are there so that I can just show you what is happening. And then we need to keep sending a heartbeat to the server saying that we are alive. Moment you're subscribed, okay, you will get a snapshot of all the symbols which you have subscribed. You'll get the previous day close, open, high, low, average. And if there is any last trade, also the bid and ask is coming. You can see the bid and the ask. So this is for one symbol. Information before the real-time data is coming. So this is all coming. This comes with snap. Whenever we fire snap, that means send us the last quote. It's a snap. It's a snapshot. So send us the snap first. So always ask for the snap first. It will give you the open, high, low, close, so that you can start measuring the change from there on. And all these things will come here. And first, all the data, all the indices also. Indices are given special codes. We give them I1, I2, I3, like for example, Nifty 50 is given a code I41. So something like that. It's given. So here, when you see C41, the small C41, that is a Nifty open and previous close. So there it is. So a little learning curve, and then all the data starts flowing. And just see the code for getting live data. Nothing. This much code, only this much code to get real-time data. That's it. You already subscribed to these symbols over here. These symbols, you can change. This token number comes from the master file. We give a master file, which you need to download every day. Even you, for velocity, every broker is giving. This is an example of a master file. These are the token numbers here. Okay. These are the token numbers. And this is the name of the stock or the name of the company and things like that. So this number has to be fired. You cannot fire this. You have to map the name of the company to the number. The exchange wants the number. So you have to map it before that, as soon as the application starts, and you have to only fire these token numbers. So when we fire these numbers, see the code. So we already subscribed for whatever symbols are subscribed by us, they are going to flow through this code. So while we are running live, this is the URL for the market data. And this is the query string. You have to give the key, which was generated earlier, the login. And you send a post request. That's it. Whatever comes back, RT data. And then you, next, like I told you, you get a sequence number in the last, for example, as of now, there's no data, but a sequence number is coming here. You can see S. This is the timestamp in Julian. And this is the sequence number. So now we pick up this sequence number and fire again. If there is no data, the same sequence number will come. That's what's happening here. You can see it's continuously firing and the same sequence number is continuously coming. Yeah, so it's just, you know, writing the same thing again and again, so you can't see. So that's what's happening. But now I have a video here. So what we've done is there's a sleep time of 0.7 seconds. Okay, it's waiting for 0.7 seconds and then firing again. So less than a sec, as it is, the data is 1 second, this thing. And if you fire, even with HTTP, you can get almost real time. It is real time only. There's hardly any difference. Let me show you. You'll be surprised to see the power of this HTTP API. And so anyway, this is the IP and your user ID and password. Logout, I already told you. Logout first, then we logged in. And again, we've already seen all this. Let's move ahead. Okay. Yeah. So this is again the list of subscribing. Same thing. This is the same code I ran in the morning. I've just taken a video of that. And there's no difference in the code. And again, same while true code. That's it. So I'm just running it here now. Let's see what happens. The code is running, it's logged in, and you can start seeing the data coming live. You are seeing the data live. See the speed. See the speed. So fast. Again, this is the logout, login, key has been picked up. You have subscribed to these symbols over here. The same account, nothing has changed. This is the snap data which has come initially. Okay, this is the key picked up, subscribe to these symbols. And this is the snap data which has come. And all this data has come, which I already explained to you. Yeah, here you can see that this is B means on the left, there's a B. That means it's a bid. Bid and ask for this symbol, 100305. And then the bid and ask. T is a trade. That means it was traded. Again, B. B is the bid and ask. All these are the indices which come index information. It comes when it changes. You can see how fast the data is flowing. And it's pretty fast. Even if you have 200 or 300, 400, it'll just come as a list and you'll just pick it up. So it's very, very powerful. And total delay with this also, you can see, sadly, is less than a second. Okay. So some people are keen on using REST, and most people I've seen, they are very comfortable with this API. It's a very, very simple API. You can build it in Node.js because it's just HTTP requests. That's it. And it can be used on websites. It can be used on your applications, desktop applications, everywhere. That's pretty simple in doing it in any language. And if you want it for any language, we can even help you with that. So that's about it from my side. Thank you very much for this opportunity.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you all. Thanks a lot for your time.